Hi, welcome to week 32 of Foundation 52. I cannot believe we're already on week 32. Man, time is flying. All right, this week we're talking about risk management. We've got two videos for you. The first one is on working with risk, and the second one is on risk mitigation. So let's dig into working with risk. Risk management is really just a fancy way of talking about knowing what risks you have and then how you deal with those risks. So managing it. And it can be, if you do it regularly, it's not a daunting task at all, right? So if you look at risk on a regular basis, then it's easier to manage than if you only look at risk when you've got a very bad situation in front of you, or you've got a big risk in front of you and you've got to figure out how to mitigate it. So you're better off looking at risk on a regular basis. Risk, I want to talk a little bit about being risk averse. And honestly, being a small business owner and being risk averse are kind of oxymorons, because having your own business is in itself a risk. And we all know that. We all knew that when we started our businesses. And it's okay, because really working for someone else is a risk as well. There's no guarantees. There's no guarantees. I think there's, how's that saying go? The only guarantees in life are death and taxes. That's true. And that your dog is going to love you. That's also a guarantee, right? Your dog will love you. But starting a small business or running a small business has some inherent risks associated with it, right? You are responsible for bringing on the revenue. You are responsible, if you have employees, for the life of your employees, not the life, but for your employees and for those employees also being paid. You have responsibilities as a small business owner, and there's some risk involved, but you took on the act of being a small business owner in spite of the fact that there was risk, and the risk that you knew about because you wanted to be an entrepreneur. You wanted to own something and control your destiny. And that's why most people start small businesses. It's because they want to control their own destiny. but, you know, risk-averse people tend to stay away from more risky types of situations or prefer to play it safer. And that's not a positive or a negative, right? So both Corey and I are, we're good with risk. We don't mind taking risks. We've been known to gamble on sports because we enjoy risk. And it's just, we have more tolerance when it comes to risk. And part of it because we're not married and don't have children, right? So we're able to just really think about ourselves and what our own personal risk tolerances are. And it makes things a little bit easier. But risk is risk, and it's there in pretty much everything you do. You're facing risk when you get in your vehicle and drive down the highway. It's not a tremendous risk, but you're facing risk. So risk is present. Now let's talk a little bit about how you identify risk. I recommend personally that you go through every area of your business and you figure out, you just look at it and say, what risks do we have here, right? So if you're going to look at marketing, for example, right? Let's just use that as an example here for identifying risk. So think about your marketing. Do you have a risk in terms of how you're marketing, like that the person who's doing your marketing for you might up and quit tomorrow? That could be a risk. Is it that you might risk offending people because nowadays everybody gets offended over everything? Sure, that's a risk. Do you have a risk that you might not hit your ROI because you're spending more on marketing than you're actually taking in revenue? Okay, mark it as a risk. Is there a risk that all of your customers are actually owned by a social media platform and you don't have any of their information? Yeah, that's a risk. Mark it down. So you just want to go through that. Do that for marketing, do it for sales, do it for human resources, do it for your processes, for the foundation of your business, for your finances. Run through everything and just list off all of the risks that you have, right? It's easy. You just want to write down everything, put it into a spreadsheet. That's the easiest way to track risks. And honestly, we give you a template for it in this week's session for tracking risks. And we like to track our risks and then rank them. But before we move away from identifying them, if you are a solopreneur, or if you have employees or you know, just you and your business partner, you want to involve other people in identifying the risk, right? Don't do this whole exercise by yourself. So even if you're a solopreneur, ask a friend or ask someone in your network, like, hey, I'm trying to do this risk identification exercise. Can you help me? Because, if you don't want to show them the risks that you've identified, you don't have to, but you can just ask them, like, what are some areas that I should think about for risk? Because you might get some really great ideas for things that you've missed. And the more comprehensive your list is, the easier it is for you to build a plan. And it's counterintuitive. I've worked on a lot of projects where we would note the risks and people would get upset. They'd be like, I don't want to list all those risks. And it's like, okay, but not listing them doesn't mean they're not there. It just means that you kind of want to bury your head in the sand versus actually acknowledge it and build a plan. So having a risk listed doesn't make it any more likely to occur than not having it listed. In fact, listing it makes it less likely to occur because you can build a mitigation strategy for it. So honestly, you want to put your efforts and energy into identifying the risks and list as many as you can. Now, once you've got all of your risks listed, everything you can think of, you want to prioritize them by the likelihood to occur and the severity. This is how we do it, right? So we just rank everything on likelihood to occur on a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being not likely at all, and 5 being, yeah, this is going to happen. And then you also want to rank it, I'm so sorry, on severity. So if it does happen, how severe is the impact to your business? 1, not severe. 5, crushing blow. Okay. So now you've got two things, the likelihood to occur and the severity if it does occur. And that's a factor. You get a score and it's a factor of those two. So if it's the likelihood is a 5 and the severity is a 5, that's a score of 25. If the likelihood's a 1, the severity is a 5, it's a score of 5. So you want to score everything and then rank them based on the score and start with the ones that have the highest score and build mitigation strategies for them. What are some things that you can do to either eliminate the risk in total or lower the impact if it does happen? Right? So you can be looking at it from a couple of different directions. And in all honesty, most risks, you're not going to be able to mitigate, but you can have a plan for how you will handle it if it occurs or how you're going to minimize the impact. And there are some risks that you're going to accept. You're going to go, yeah, we'll accept that risk and we're just going to keep moving forward, right? The risk of COVID-21 happening. I couldn't even tell you how to score it. At this point, I'd probably score it a 5. The likelihood that it will happen, the impact to your business, I don't know. I feel like you're probably, if you've survived COVID-19, you probably have some plans in place. So maybe it's a 2, right? So now your score is a 10. And I mean, is there anything you can do? Yeah, I guess you can make sure that you've got your hand sanitizers and your masks in place and you've got a policy or a process for your customers to know what it is. But aside from that, there's not really a lot you can do. So you're just going to kind of accept that risk, have a plan in place, keep it moving. And that's what you do. You do that for every risk that you have listed. You score it. You score for impact, you score for severity, and then you come up with a mitigation strategy and you decide if you're going to accept that risk or not, where you're just like, yeah, that one's going to happen and there's not really anything I can do about it. And you should then revisit your risk list and risk register is what we call it, at least monthly, weekly if you can. The more frequently that you look at it, the more easy it is to track. And you'll get to the point where it'll take you 30 minutes a week to go through all of your risks and just make updates and keep moving. So that is the recommended approach that we have. You want to track them. You want to identify them. The more familiar you are with the risks to your business, the better you are at managing through it. So don't ignore it. Just hit it head on, manage it, and go from there. If you have any questions, reach out. This is one of our favorite topics, and we love helping people with risk. So do not be afraid to reach out to us if you need some help. If you've got some questions, we are here to answer them. And you can always hit us up on the monthly live Q&A as well. We look forward to talking to you more about risk if you need some help. Thanks.